Viewer discretion is advised.
How many more Americans must die at the hands of illegal aliens before our borders are secured?
Raise your hand if your government plan would provide coverage for undocumented immigrants.
These people don't care about the American dream. They're pillaging and plundering the American taxpayers. But nobody wants to talk about that, except Donald Trump.
And the Democrats won votes.
So the Democrats want open borders. Let everybody come in. Let everybody pour in. We don't care. Let them come in from the Middle East. Let them come in from all over the place. We don't care.
So as Attorney General and the Chief Law Officer of the state of California, I issued a directive to the sheriffs of my state that they did not have to comply with detainers.
Democrats don't care about the impact of uncontrolled migration on your communities, your schools, your hospitals, your jobs, or your safety.
The problem is that right now, the criminalization statute is what gives Donald Trump the ability to take children away from their parents.
Beginning next week, the Obama administration plans to begin sending home some of the thousands of children and families who crossed into the U.S. illegally from Central America.
Senator, just to clarify, would you decriminalize illegal border crossings?
The point is not about criminalization. That has given Donald Trump the tool.
Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson toured a temporary immigration detention facility in Artesia, New Mexico, Friday. It's one of several locations now housing thousands of children and families who recently crossed the border illegally.
The president asked Congress for emergency funding of $1.8 billion for housing, food, and health care. He also wants $1.6 billion to build new detention facilities.
Democrats put illegal immigrants before they put American citizens. What the hell is going on?
But the women and children on that border that are trying to seek refuge are acting more American than any person who seeks to keep them out ever will be.
At least 50% of these criminal aliens being released back into the public will reoffend the first year. 75% will reoffend within 5 years. This is a victimization of the American community. This isn't America I grew up in. We got to take these sanctuary cities on. We got to take them to court. And we got to start charging some of these politicians with crimes.
Should someone who is here without documents, and that is his only offense, should that person be deported?
That person should not be the focus of deportation. We should fundamentally change the way we deal with them.
It is a position of every Democrat on that stage that illegal immigrants, if they cross the border illegally, should get health care for life.
Right. We found out that 31-year-old Sergio Martinez has a long history of being deported to Mexico and then illegally re-entering the U.S. He's been deported 20 times, to be exact.
It is then the position of every Democrat on that stage that if they cross the border illegally, it's not even illegal anymore. Now, that may make Democrats feel really good about themselves.
Police say 31-year-old Sergio Martinez broke into a Northeast Portland apartment at sunrise Monday morning and attacked a 65-year-old woman he didn't know, stole her car, and that night attacked another woman while wielding a knife in a parking garage. Again, a stranger.
My first look at a lot of these people, I would have thought, well, the Democrats really, 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 really care about illegal immigrants.
On day one, I will make sure that, number one, we end the ICE policies and the customs and border policies that are violating the human rights.
If you could, would you take the wall down now? Here.
Yes.
Like you have a wall.
Absolutely.
Knock it down.
Tell it to the people of Montgomery County, Maryland, right outside Washington, D.C. This week, authorities there charged a Salvadoran national called Nelson Reyes Medrano with raping a teenage girl at knife point. Reyes Medrano is at least the fifth illegal immigrant arrested for rape in Montgomery County just this month. Five, just this month. Two of the others are charged with raping an 11-year-old girl. The details are horrifying. How'd this happen? Simple. Montgomery County is a sanctuary for criminal aliens. The chances of illegal immigrants being deported from Montgomery County are essentially zero, even if they're dangerous. The left-wing ideologues who run the place let this happen. They're denying it now, of course, but they absolutely did it.
when it cracked down against a butcherous gang known as MS-13 on Long Island. A grand jury in Nassau County indicting 17 alleged gang members and associates on charges of murder and conspiracy and drug trafficking.
Victor Lopez is among them. Prosecutors say he killed Angel Soler of Roosevelt last July. He was found mutilated and buried in cement.
Here's who'll be eligible for health care coverage under California's Medicaid program. Undocumented immigrants between the ages of 19 and 25. That's about 90,000 people. The cost to California taxpayers, $98 million.
Now they're saying that they want free health care, illegal aliens do. But let's get this straight, Neil. There is no such thing as free health care. Money needs to be taken out of someone's paycheck in order to fund this. So now they want to take money out of an American citizen's paycheck and give it to an illegal alien. Neil, that's absolutely crazy. This country should be the land of opportunity, like you said, the land of freedom, of liberty, not the land of free stuff. And that's what this country is turning into. What kind of people are we attracting when we have all of this free stuff? People should want to come here to open a business, not to get free things. And that's what's happening.
Republicans love to tell us that undocumented immigrants are coming over to the United States and just committing crimes left and right. In fact, Donald Trump basically launched his entire presidential bid on that claim, telling us that people were coming up illegally across the southern border to rape and kill us. That was their goal. Just hopping that border, raping and killing their way across this great country. But as it turns out, new research actually shows that that's literally not true.
An Uber driver who is living in the country illegally is charged with raping, assaulting, and robbing young women in California. Four victims have been identified, and there could be more in counties northwest of Los Angeles.
An 18-year-old illegal immigrant on a rape charge in Hicksville, Ohio, made his first appearance in court today. Clementino Kojuk, who had been living in the village of Hicksville, faces one count of felony rape.
A 23-year-old dreamer in Washington State is accused of brutally raping a 19-year-old woman in her apartment complex's gym and leaving her with severe facial injuries.
And in fact, areas with larger populations of undocumented immigrants have not seen any increase in crimes.
Marilyn Ferris was home alone asleep when police say she was sexually assaulted, strangled, and beaten in the head with a hammer. She died a week later. One of her alleged attackers is 29-year-old Victor Martinez Ramirez, in the U.S. illegally, in trouble previously with the law.
That county mother is brutally raped and her child was in the room during the horrific attack. Police say two teenage boys committed the violent act and a third teen, a girl, is also charged in the case.
According to investigators, Palencia and Ramirez, dressed in black and wearing ski masks, were waiting for the victim when she arrived home from work with her two children at around 3 a.m. The teens threw boiling water on her, shocked the woman with a stun gun, then forced her into her bedroom where they raped her. One of her children witnessed the crime. All three suspects charged with home invasion, rape, aggravated sodomy, kidnapping, aggravated battery, and cruelty to children.
So this new set of statistics, this new data, it shows that the biggest Republican claims about undocumented immigrants, like so many other Republican claims, is an absolute lie. It's a myth, it's a fantasy that they created to scare people into voting for Republicans.
His first conviction was in 2018 for the rape of a six-year-old. During the prosecution, more victims came forward. Yesterday, he was convicted of sexual molestation and rape of a six- and 10-year-old.
This land was Mexican once, was Indian always, and is, and will be again. And me, as a Mexicana, que tiene raíces yaqui, I feel it's our right to be here. We do not need a white man to be telling us that he's gonna build a wall against in our land. This is our land, and we want him out.
Happening now, the retrial begins for Constantino Banda, who prosecutors say was drunk and angry from a fight last May when he caused a hit and run that severely injured a six-year-old boy named Lennox Lake of San Ysidro.
Behavior that's landed two teenagers behind bars, 17-year-old Edgar Chicas Hernandez and 19-year-old Victor Gonzalez Gutierrez. Court documents say the pair kidnapped a teenage girl at knife point outside her boyfriend's Frederick home earlier this month. then took her to a nearby apartment where they kept her prisoner and raped her for hours. The teen suspects are both in county lockup on rape, kidnapping, sodomy, and assault charges. And today we're learning ICE is also now on the case, slapping one of those accused rapists with an immigration detainer.
Doug, what happened here on Highway 78 just up the road was nothing short of horrific. A father and two young children killed in a head-on collision. Prosecutors last week got the harshest sentence possible for the undocumented immigrant responsible. But the victim's widow wants to see laws changed that would make those here in the country illegally more accountable.
That day in March last year, Peter had just picked up the kids and was driving back to their home in Levon on Highway 78. Their car was struck head-on, killing all three. Margarito Quintero Rosales told authorities he fell asleep at the wheel and his van drifted into the oncoming lane.
He was here illegally. He drove illegally. He was working illegally. And he killed three innocent people.
Investigators tell us Felix Briones raped a woman who lived just two doors down from him. The Mobile County Sheriff's Office says Briones started touching the woman inappropriately, and when she tried to get away, he forced her into her home and raped her.
That is 100% the end goal of these Republican lies, no matter who they're coming from. They want more people to vote for Republicans because they want to scare you into thinking there is an imminent threat. The others are going to get you.
Judge Gregory Moeller says it's one of the most abominable and heartbreaking cases he's ever seen. And Tuesday morning in this Teton County courthouse, he told 32-year-old Marcos Navarez Zamora that he destroyed an 11-year-old girl's life by repeatedly raping her, eventually impregnating her. Moeller told the admitted rapist that he traumatized the young child, then ordered him to serve 32 years in prison, 10 years fixed, 22 years indeterminate. Now, Narvaez Zamora must also register as a sex offender and pay a fine and restitution, some of that money going to the 12-year-old girl. She is currently living with her mother. As for the baby, it has been placed in a home for adoption.
Jose Tofilla Lopez came to court this morning with a lot hanging over his head. The first order of business, through an interpreter, a guilty plea to rape for reportedly getting a friend's 15-year-old daughter drunk and assaulting her after she passed out.
He forcibly raped a teenage girl.
But first, for the second time in as many weeks, two illegal immigrants have been arrested and charged with sex abuse.
Authorities say the woman had just left the home after an argument with her boyfriend when she ran into Antonio Flores and Castillejos Martinez here. Deputies say the men, both illegal immigrants, started touching her. They were ultimately charged with sex abuse, first degree, and also burglary.
A Sanford man is charged with sexually assaulting a three-year-old little girl. And police say the accused was in the country illegally.
Tragedy in Indiana. Indianapolis Colts linebacker Edwin Jackson and rideshare driver Jeffrey Monroe were hit and killed by a suspected drunk driver on Sunday morning, the day of the Super Bowl. Police have identified the driver as an illegal immigrant driving without a license, twice deported between 2007 and 2009.
The murder of a Central California police officer is where we begin today. It is escalating the immigration debate. Investigators say the suspect was in this country illegally. They believe he's still in the area. They are asking local residents to help find him.
And here's how the shooting allegedly happened. Police Corporal Roneel Singh was shot and killed during a traffic stop just hours after Christmas.
Now is the time for Congress to show the world that America is committed to ending illegal immigration and putting the ruthless coyotes, cartels, drug dealers and human traffickers out of business.
Crime actually went down. It went down. So those areas with more undocumented immigrants are actually seeing less crime than ever now.
You sound like a bitch, nigga.